Hi everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video I'm gonna talk about marriage in Turkey. I decided to make a part 1 and a part 2 of this video because in part 1, so this video, I will be talking about Turkey in general, how the dating life in Turkey is and how the process of marriage is here in Turkey. And in part 2, I'm gonna talk about my experience of marrying here in Turkey. If you are new here on my channel, I'm a Dutch girl and I'm living in Marmaris, Turkey, and I've been living here now for about 5 years, and I've also been married for 5 years with a Turkish man. So in that 5 years I learned a little bit about how the process goes here with Turkish people but also with expats here in Turkey. And a little disclaimer, I don't want to offend anybody, and if I say something wrong, please correct me in the comments down below. This video is just for fun and just my experience here. So yes, if you're excited to see the video, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. And now let's get started. Okay, so the first question I get a lot is how the dating life is here in Turkey. And yeah, it really depends on where you are, I think. The first thing that is maybe nice to know is that Turkey is a Muslim country. So I feel like that in smaller cities or villages, it's a little bit more secret. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think in like bigger cities they are a little bit more open and they can go to like restaurants and all of that. But I feel that in more traditional Turkish families, the daughters get really protected, so they don't have a chance to go out with a lot of guys, like to date with different people. So what I see here is that usually people keep it a secret a little bit. And then usually when they get engaged, like they put photos from each other on Facebook and Instagram. So I feel like it's a bit secret till they are really sure about it. So I would say it's sometimes the same, like for example in the Netherlands, but also sometimes it's a bit different, depends on the family and maybe their beliefs. And then what I really love here is how they get engaged. So what will happen is that the boy's family will go over to the girl's family, and I really love this tradition, and that is that the girl makes a small cup of Turkish coffee for her boyfriend or soon to be husband, and she puts salt in it. And then when the man drinks the coffee, he doesn't have to pull like dirty faces or have to say something about it. He just have to drink it all up, even though it stays disgusting. I'm not sure why they do that. I think it's like a test if he's a good man or not, but it's just a really fun tradition that they do. And also the man has to bring some presents for the girl. I'm not sure if they have to give gold right away, but yes, they do have to give something. I think in the past also both parents have to agree, and I'm not really sure if it's still like that. It's a little bit more modern now. I mean, if the boy and the girl want to get married, they are getting married, but it's just still a tradition that both parents visit each other and yes, talk about life and things. And also sometimes they have like a engagement party, like to make it official. And what they also have is two rings. They have like a ribbon or a tie, I'm not really sure how you call it, and they cut it with a scissor, and then they're officially engaged. So here in Turkey, and I believe in a lot of countries, you can choose if you want to marry at City Hall or that you want to marry at your location. And what I saw is that most people choose for City Hall, so they will have their official wedding on a different date than the actual wedding party. In part 2 I will talk about everything what I did. But when you marry in Turkey, you get this book, and this is like a little family book. I'm not gonna show the inside because all of my personal information is in here. So here is the date that you get married and in what city, and my husband's name and where he was born. But what I find really funny is that both our parents' names are in here. I believe on the Turkish kimlik, the little ID card, is also writing your parents' names. So my husband's father and mother's name, and also mine. And there's a little stamp on it, and there's also a different page for your future children. So yes, when you marry in Turkey, you will get this little book, and of course you have to be careful that you don't lose it. So yes, I think that is really nice to have. So usually the night before the wedding party, they will have a nikah party. And a nikah party is like a henna night, and sometimes it's only for girls, but I see here a lot it get mixed up. The girl doesn't wear her wedding dress yet, but she wears like a red dress or like a pink one. Also a really beautiful dress, obviously. And it's just like a party night, and they will apply henna on her hands, both on the girl's and the boy's hand, and they will put gold on it, and also on her dress they will put gold. And this is just like an extra party night. Let me know in the comments down below what it used to be, but what I saw is just like an extra wedding day. So then on the actual wedding day, the party, usually the boy will pick up the girl and she will say goodbye to her family. And this is something really emotional. I saw a lot of girls doing this, and they're always crying. Their parents, usually their moms, are crying a lot. And it's really emotional because, yes, she's saying goodbye to her family and her home where she lived for many years. So I think this is also a really beautiful tradition. And the father wraps a red band around her wedding dress. And I'm not really sure why they do that, but yes, it's really beautiful as well. It's like he gave her away, I guess. Then when the boy picked up the girl from her family, they will all go together to the salon, wherever the party is. And yes, there's always traditional music. It's like four people usually, one with like a drum, one with like a little guitar, and there's also, yeah, all different instruments that play Turkish traditional music. They also dance differently. It's always like this. It's really fun. I love to dance. And again, it really depends on where you are from. But I am from Marmaris, and here they dance all like this. But if you go to more of the east of Turkey, they dance all together like this. Yeah, it's really fun, all different kind of dances. Then what is also really typical for a Turkish wedding is that they put the money and the gold on the dresses. So first they will party, and then after a while they will do like that ceremony that they all put gold and money on the dress and on the suit from the men. They have usually like fabric so they can remove it after everyone gave their present. And that is also something that I found really funny, because in the Netherlands we give like an envelope and nobody can see how much you gave. But here in Turkey, everyone can see exactly how much you put on there. And I'm not sure why they do that. Maybe because if you give, for example, 100 liras, they will give you again 100 liras. Maybe it works like that. But yes, I found that really funny when I saw that first. Turkish weddings are also over the top. Every girl wears beautiful dresses, have their hair and makeup done. In the Netherlands, of course, we have also nice dresses, but not like this. And of course, what they do in Turkey, if the bride and the groom are both Muslim, they also marry for the imam. So they are also married for their religion, if that makes sense. So yeah, if they're both Muslim, they will also do that. So this is basically how it goes here in Turkey. If you would like to add something, let me know in the comments down below. And like I said, in part 2, I'm going to talk all about my wedding here in Turkey and my experience with dress shopping. And all of that I will tell you in part 2. So if you would like to see that, make sure you subscribe so you won't miss it. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up and go follow me on Instagram. And I hope to see you guys very soon in one of my other videos. Bye!